Hello everyone, thank you very much for watching this video. I got a question about the difference between HTTP filters, aspects and interceptors, and in this video I want to answer this question and give you examples to understand what the HTTP filters are, aspects and interceptors, and of course the differences between them. I will also use some diagrams from my books Spring Security in Action and Spring Quickly. Hopefully with them and with the projects I will create together with you, you will properly understand the differences between the HTTP filters, aspects and interceptors. So first let's start with HTTP filters. It's important to mention from the very beginning that HTTP filters only work with web applications. That's a reason why they are called HTTP filters. So the HTTP filters, their role is to intercept HTTP requests, and we can use them to alter the request and the response. It's about HTTP request and response. Now I would like, using this diagram from my Spring Quickly chapter 7, to remind you how the Spring MVC class design looks like, because here is also where we will fit in the filter chain in my example. And you know that when you write a web application, somewhere in a controller component we have methods that are called actions, and they are basically called as a result of a request sent by a client. So the client sends a request. In behind the scenes, it's intercepted by the application. Some component named dispatcher servlet finds out who is from the control side, who is responsible for that specific request. So it's mapping the request to a specific controller action. And then the controller action goes further to the controller and it's executed. Now, it's important also now to say that before the action, you might have multiple filters. So you can add one or more filters that will compose what we call the filter chain. It's a chain of filters because each filter delegates to the next one that might delegate to another one that in the end will delegate to the controller. So the end of the filter chain is basically the controller action that has been intercepted. So this is how the filter, this is how you can imagine the filter chain. I will use now a diagram from my Spring Security in Action. You find the filters explained in Spring Security in Action because the Spring Security authentication and authorization class design and architecture for web applications is based on filters. So this is only one responsibility where filters are applicable. There are many other things that you can implement using filters. But the idea is the HTTP request is intercepted by a filter, which can then delegate to a next filter, which can delegate to another filter, and in the end it will delegate to the controller. Then of course the response comes back, and the response can be altered by each filter, and then it's delivered back to the client that initially sent the request. So basically we can imagine the filter as an interceptor of the HTTP request. Let's also have a demonstration on how to implement such a filter in a Spring Boot application. So I prepared here an IntelliJ for you, where I will create a new project, and let me create a Spring Initializer project. I will name it Demo Filters. And the only thing I need is to add the Spring Web Dependency. So I'm creating a new application, a new web application. And for the beginning, let's simply create a controller here. Say new controllers. And create a class Demo Controller. I will annotate this class with REST controller. And I will make it the controller of a demo endpoint that simply returns demo. We will access this endpoint using HTTP GET and the path demo. I start the application without adding first any filter to show you how it works when we don't have a filter. And then you will see, of course, how the response will be changed when we will add a filter, so that you easily see that the filter that we defined correctly works. So I'm going into a postman and I will just say localhost 8080, which is the default port and demo. And you can see the demo response comes back with a 200 OK status. And if I take a look in the headers, you will see some headers that have been added, but you see only 5 headers. Let's say that what we'd like to do with a filter here is adding a response header. So we would like to alter the HTTP response by adding one more header to these 5, which are already set by our application. Of course, it's only one thing you can do with the filter. There are any kinds of alterings on the HTTP request and HTTP response that you can do when applying a filter. But this will be an easy demonstration for us to see that a filter works and how to implement it. So I'm going back to Postman, and here I'm adding a filters package. I really like using packages to organize my code. Demo filter. And to be a filter, it simply needs to implement the filter interface. And mind that the correct filter interface is the one from JavaX Servlet. We have to override the doFilter method. And you see in the doFilter method, we actually get access to the request and the response. And in order to forward to the next filter or to the controller action, a filter always needs to use the filter chain, doFilter, and call further the next filter or the controller with the request and the response. This request and response being also possible to change them prior to calling the next filter in the chain. Of course, in order to see this implementation, Spring needs a bin in its context. So we really need to make sure somehow, either by using the component annotation or a bin method in the configuration class, that we make it an instance in the Spring context. Otherwise, Spring not having an instance won't do anything with the filter. So to configure the filter, we really need to make sure that we have this as an instance in Spring's context. Of course, I wanted to show you somehow that this is working, and my suggestion was to add an HTTP header to the response. So let's change this response to an HTTP servlet response. We can easily do this by casting the servlet response, of course, and then adding a header, say message, with a value like Luke, I'm your father. Cool. So we don't need to do anything else than this. By adding a bin in Spring's context that implements the filter interface, Spring automatically knows here. I'm using Spring Boot, so basically that's maybe the reason. It's basically the reason why this happens. So Spring Boot will know to add this as a filter in the filter chain prior to any of the requests. So I only now need to rerun the application, and when I will recall in my Postman the same endpoint, now the header appears here and you see the value that I set in the filter. So the filter works correctly. Now what's important to consider about filters is that they only refer to HTTP requests and the HTTP response. So it's a component that intercepts the HTTP request and response. You won't have HTTP filters in an app that is not a web app. And it only refers to the HTTP request and response, not to a specific method, even though it looks like it's intercepting the controller action. It's not right to say that's intercepting the controller action. It's basically intercepting the HTTP request and response. And I say that because this will be a difference to what we discuss next, aspects and interceptors, where you will see that interceptors, they refer to methods. We use aspects and interceptors to intercept methods that can be in any kind of application. It might be a web app, but it don't necessarily needs to be a web app, so it can be any kind of application. And an aspect, it simply is designed to intercept a method, whatever that method is, and it doesn't matter how it's been called. You might have a schedule process that called that method, you might have an HTTP request, or you might have a timer, or you might have something else. When the method is called, an aspect intercepts it. So unlike the HTTP filter that only applies to HTTP requests, an aspect applies to any method of your Java application. And now, of course, let's do also let's also take a look on a diagram to make sure that you can visually understand how the aspects apply. So this is a diagram from my Spring Quickly, chapter 6, where I present aspects in detail. You might want to read this chapter to see even more details about aspects than I will tell you now in this video. When you call, say, the publish comment method of a component of a comment service bean, which is a component in your Spring application, if there is no aspect configured, then the call will go directly to that method. But if you have an aspect configured, then the aspect acts as a proxy to that object. So the aspect intercepts the call and might alter the logic. And in some cases, it might even decide not to delegate further. Like in the case of HTTP filters that can decide not to delegate further in the filter chain, so cut the chain at some point and for some reason. Same with aspects. Aspects may decide they don't want to go further to the intercepted method and they want to cut the chain. So they look very similar, but the difference is, again, HTTP filters, they are related to HTTP requests, while aspects are related to method calls, any method calls. So let's also create an application to demonstrate how an aspect works. So I'll create another application demo aspects. It will be a web application, but again, mind that it's not necessarily to have aspects within web apps. It might be any kind of an application. It's just easier now for my demonstration to make it a web app. And in order to work with aspects, we'll have to also add the aspects dependency in the pom.xml file of my Maven project here, because I'm using Maven as a build tool, as you have seen. So that would be Spring Framework, Spring Aspects. And then always, in my case, I have to go and say reload project to make sure that I really get the dependencies downloaded and configured. And now I will do the same thing, but instead of having only one controller, I will also add a service to my application. Why am I adding a service? Because instead of intercepting the controller action, I want to make sure it's clear for you that the aspects are intercepting methods and they are not related necessarily to the HTTP request and response. As I said, you might even have aspects in services that are not web apps. So for that reason, I will still implement a demo controller, but I will apply my aspect to a service class. So I will have a demo service. Demo service will simply be a service of my Spring app with a simple method returning a string. And then in my demo controller, which will still be a REST controller and will implement an endpoint to return a string, but in this case I would like this method to call the service method and return what the service method returns. So now what I will do, I will say private final demo service, and if I chose to make it final, then I have to define a constructor and do the dependency injection by constructor. And the idea is I return here whatever the demo method of the service returns. So if I now start this application, I again should see nothing in my postman other than just the demo string in the body. So in the body, if I send, then I see just the demo string, 200 OK, only 5 headers, because this is what I implemented. Now, instead of adding a filter, let's create an aspect. To create an aspect in a Spring application, you first need to create a class and you annotate it with aspect. Then you need to make sure you define a bin in the Spring context, otherwise the framework won't be able to manage it. So you can define the bin of this class in the Spring context by adding bin annotated method in the configuration class, or you can simply use a stereotype annotation like component. Let's choose this approach. It's not relevant the way you choose to make it a bin in the Spring context. But one thing I should have done prior to this is make sure I also enable my configuration, my aspect capabilities in this application. And you do this with the configuration class, because mind that the aspects capabilities, they are not by default enabled. So you need a configuration class and you need to add the enable aspect gautoproxy annotation above it. Otherwise, your aspects won't be called. So you need to make sure you don't forget this. And now what do we do? We want to intercept this method. So in this case, what you need to do is write public string, say, demo method, which will be the aspect logic, and using an advice annotation like around. Spring provides us 5 advice annotations. Around is the most powerful of them, but we also have before, after throwing, and after returning. I have another video on this channel where I discuss aspects. You can take a look on that one to see them more in detail. And then using an aspect J expression language, I will say that this one, this aspect logic will be called at the execution of the com example demo aspects service, demo service, demo method. So this is the aspect J expression language mapping this aspect logic to precisely our demo method in the demo service class. And if I say here return hello, now you see how I don't necessarily even delegate to my real class. So now you can see, I remind you, when I called it, it was demo in the response body. But now if I restart, I say stop and rerun. So I restart this application and I call again the same endpoint. Instead of demo, it appeared hello. Why? Because this logic intercepted the method and didn't delegate further to the real method. It simply got this hello and returned it back to the controller. So for the controller, it looks like it calls the demo service. But this call is intercepted by my aspect here. And instead of calling the real method, now the controller gets back from the aspect this hello, which is then of course returned back to the client, and that's why in the Postman body you see hello and not demo. But you can choose to delegate the real method. Then you need to use the proceeding join point. And the proceeding join point is the representation of the intercepted method. And then you can say something like this, say proceeding join point proceed. And if I leave it like this, of course there are two things we need to change here. First of all, we need to throw the throwable, and secondly, you need to make it an object here, the response, the return type, because you don't know what method you generally intercept here. In an aspect, you could intercept whatever method, so they might have any return type. So in order to cover all of them, you put object. You can even alter the response. You can say and the smiley face here, and then what will happen is that my aspect intercepts the method, it calls the method returns demo as a string, that string is concatenated with the smiley face, and then in the response you will see demo space and the smiley face. So you can alter from the aspect, you can alter the response, and see demo smiley face. So again, HTTP filters, they are in front of the controller action. They might form a chain, but they rely on having an HTTP request and response. So they are only something that we can discuss of when we have a web app. While aspects, they intercept methods. Same as for the HTTP filters, you might have multiple aspects in a chain. And as you have seen, the chain might break at some point. So one aspect might decide it doesn't want to delegate it further, the request. But in this case, aspects are for method calls, while filters are for HTTP requests. So they are similar, but they apply differently. And now, what about interceptors? Because the question initially was the difference between HTTP filters, aspects, and interceptors. Well, you shouldn't be surprised to tell you that aspects and interceptors are actually the same thing, but they are different terminologies. Aspects being what we use in general with aspect-oriented programming, coming from AspectJ, very old, and the oldest, say, framework that implemented this pattern. And in terms of Spring, we call aspects these proxies whose purpose is to intercept the method calls, while interceptors are kind of the same thing but in Jakarta IE applications. So let's see if we can also now implement an interceptor and demonstrate how an interceptor works in a Jakarta IE application, and you will see that is more or less the same thing. And I say more or less the same thing because if you take a look in Spring aspects are a little bit more customizable. You see here I used a round, but I was telling you earlier that you have multiple advice options here, like before, after, after throwing, after returning. While in case of the Jakarta interceptors, you only have the around. It's also a little bit more rigid in terms of syntaxes. I have to be honest with you, I didn't use interceptors for a long time, but I don't think a lot of things changed in that direction. I might be wrong, but what I will show you is most probably all of the interceptors. So they are a little bit more light than Spring aspects, but they do represent the same thing. They are just some proxies intercepting methods in the end. That's what they do. So I will have the courage to actually try to create a Jakarta IE application. I hope it will work. So I will choose this Java Enterprise here, and I just installed previously a Glassfish 6 to demonstrate this as an application server. And let's say next. And I actually want to use Jakarta IE, not Java IE. So I will choose Jakarta IE 9. And the web profile should give me enough. And how do I call it? Demo interceptor, maybe? And say terminate here. Okay, IntelliJ created me this demo application. Let's take a look on how it looks like now, and if we want to change anything. I think first of all, yes, very important. It's not okay to use Java 15 with Jakarta E9. Actually, with Glassfish, I'm not sure even if 11 is okay. So I think just for safety, I will go to an 8. Go to a Java 8. So it might be that 11 would have worked as well, but since I didn't use it ever in an example, now I will just go to what I know. What's this error? Require string, provided string. So this is an IntelliJ error, we don't care. Okay. But I would like to call it demo because that's how I used it previously as well. And let's return a demo actually here. And let's try to start the application, see if it's working. Okay, my Glassfish looks to have started successfully. The port should still be 8080. And very important, it opened this demo page here. Very important for us is actually this namespace where our app has been deployed, because that this one demo shouldn't work directly. It will be slash this one slash demo, and it might even have a prefix on the application level here, which is slash API. So it should be slash API slash demo. Okay, and we finally see the result demo here. Now the interceptors. So I can do the same thing here. Let me do the same thing. First of all, I would like to try to create a service just to give it the same structure. So I say service, demo service, and use the same thing we've done in the Spring application, but now we use Jakarta IE. And for some reason, for some reason, it doesn't show me the annotations. Okay, IntelliJ, I thought you are smart. Okay, that's a very interesting one. So I don't think it happened to me before to not be able to use annotations on a class. And I'm pretty sure it's not my fault. Wow. Okay. Let's try something else then. So say demo service. No, still doesn't work. It still seems to be a problem with IntelliJ because my application actually works correctly. So we might want to rebuild it for something like this first. No, it still doesn't work. I think this situation happened when I changed the Java version. So what if I change it back? I'm really curious if this is a bug in IntelliJ with the Java version. What was it, 15? Yeah, it really is with the Java version, so oh my god, I will report this one. So anyway, let's see if now it's working actually. Stateless, it really works now. So this is really a bug in IntelliJ. I will report it. But now it's irrelevant. We will probably have to change it back to Java 8, but let's try to finish our implementation here. So string demo, and say return demo. And my first idea was I would like to actually inject this here just to give you the same application. So say demo service, and then here I have to actually use the AGB annotation to make the injection, and then I should actually call the demo method. And probably if I try to run it now, it won't work because I doubt it will work with Java 15, but maybe it works. Let's try it. If not, I will go back to Java 8. I'm not sure if it did something. Let me try to restart the server completely. Okay, and that's expected, so it doesn't work because of the Java 15. So I'm going back to Java 8. And Java 8. Restart server. So it started again to give me the error, but again it's from IntelliJ. Because we clearly see now that the application was successfully deployed. Okay. Can you imagine I paid the money for IntelliJ? And we just call it to make sure that it does the same thing. And now that we know it does the same thing, so I will actually try to now change back to. Sorry for that, guys. So it shouldn't work like that, but it's IntelliJ who seems not to allow me properly work. So I will have to do that to demonstrate you. Or if you find some other solution, let me know. But the idea is that it seems I have to do that. Interceptors. And in the interceptors, I will create a demo interceptor. And in the demo interceptor, I will say interceptor, and then the interceptor should have a method which, and this one I think is mandatory, should return object. You have seen me in the Spring example with the aspect in the first call. I was able to simply say public string something, and I returned the string. And I didn't need to throw any exception, but in this case, in this one, it's really mandatory. I do throwable, and I return object. So if I remember correctly, you can't do it another way around, so it's mandatory you do it like this. And then of course can just say like we did in the example, just return hello here. And then around invoke should be the annotation. And to link this to the method, it's something like interceptors here, say interceptors, and then you enumerate the interceptors, which in my case is the demo interceptor class. Okay. It gives me an error here, say interceptor must specify at least a binding, but I just put the binding, so I will make a bet this is still from IntelliJ, not from myself, and hopefully I'm right. But again, I need to change it back to Java 8. 8 again, and just to make sure, I will say restart server. So it gave me an error. Method demo defined is not defined according to specification. Indeed, around invoke it does not have exactly one parameter. Yeah, that's right. So again, I was saying that unlike aspects, in case of interceptors, you really have to have the right specification. So in my case here, it was. Actually invocation handler or something like this, or invocation context, sorry, so invocation context. The invocation context is basically more or like the more or less the same as the proceeding join point. So when you say context, you can then invoke the method that has been intercepted. So that's the invocation context. So let me try now again, restart. I feel a little bit uncomfortable when I see all these errors, but I know they are not my errors, but I still feel uncomfortable to see the errors. Okay, my application started again, and I will try to call the demo endpoint, and indeed you see hello. So that's what I wanted to show you. The interceptor intercepted the method call, and like in my first example on the Spring application, it returned hello. Okay, and if you really want, you can say something like context, proceed, and if we do something like a smiley face, then this should actually work precisely like the example we had in the Spring application with the aspects. So the conclusion being, interceptors and aspects are more or less the same thing. They do intercept methods. The interceptor is terminology used by Jakarta IE, prior known as Java IE. And the syntax is a little bit more rigid. So you've seen when I tried to use the method and didn't use the parameter, it didn't start. So I really need to correctly fulfill everything in the specification. While in case of the Spring aspects, I have a little bit more liberty. I only have the around invoke here. From my knowledge, while in Spring, you also have a before, after, throwing, after, returning, and after. So you have five advice methods, not only one. But in they are the same thing. So they do intercept methods. And you see indeed the demo and the smiley face. And in both of them, you can decide not to delegate to the method. You can decide to alter its parameters. You can decide to alter its behavior. So from this point of view, they mostly work the same. And I think with these three examples, we concluded the demonstration. And hopefully it's more clear for you now what's the difference between an HTTP filter, an aspect, and an interceptor. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much for staying here with me, and hope to see you for other videos later. Have a great time for study further. Cheers.